was an early morning barroom, and the place just opened up, and a little man came in so fast, and he started at his cups. And the broader served the whiskey, she was a big old friendly girl, who tried to fight her empty nights by smiling at the world. And she said, hey bub, it's been a while since you've been around. Where the hell you been hiding, and why you look so down? The little man just sat there like he'd never heard a sound. The waitress, she gave out with a cough, and acting not the least put off, she spoke once again. She said, I don't want to bother you, consider it's understood. I know I'm not no beauty queen, but I sure can listen good. And the little man took his drink in his hand, and he raised it to his lips. He took a couple of sips, and then he told that waitress this story. I am the midnight watchman down at Miller's Tool and Die, and I watch the metal rusting, I watch the time go by. A week ago at the diner, I stopped to get a bite, and this here lovely lady, she sat two seats from my right. And Lord, Lord, Lord,
Lord, Lord, Lord,
she was all right. You see, she was so damn beautiful that she could walk the winter frost. But she looked long past lonely and well nigh under lost. Now I'm not much of a mover or a pick-em-up easy guy, but I decided to glide on over and give her one good try. Lord, Lord, Lord,
Lord, Lord, Lord,
she was worth the try. Well, I was tongue-tied like a schoolboy, I stammered out some words. It did not seem to matter much, 'cause I don't think she heard. She just looked clear on through me to a space back in my head, and it chained me into silence as quietly she said, if you want me to come with you, that's all right with me, 'cause I know I'm going nowhere, and anywhere's a better place to be. I drove her to my boarding house, and I took her up to my room, and I went to turn on the only light to brighten up the gloom. But she said, please leave the light on, oh, I don't mind the dark. And as her clothes all tumbled round her, I could hear my heart. She lay back in my bed. It was the kind of scene I only had imagined in my head. I just could not believe it, to think that she was real. As I tried to tell her, she said, I know just how you feel. And if you want to come here with me, that's all right with me. 'Cause I've been oh so lonely, loving someone is a better way to be. Anywhere's a better place to be. Well, the morning came so swiftly, I held her in my arms, and she slept like a baby, snug and safe from harm. I did not want to share her or dare to break the mood. So before she woke, I went out to buy us both some food. I came back with my paper bag, to find that she was gone. She'd left a 6-word letter saying, it's time that I moved on. You know that waitress, she took her bar rag and she wiped it across her eyes. And as she spoke, her voice came out as something like a sigh. She said, I wish that I was beautiful, or that you were halfway blind. And I wish I weren't so goddamn fat. I wish that you were mine. And I wish that you'd come with me when I leave for home. For we both know all about emptiness and living all alone. And the little man looked at the empty glass in his hand, and he smiled a crooked grin. He said, I guess I'm out of gin, and I know we both have been so long. A better place to be. Thank you very much. God, sounds good up here. I hope it sounds, you know, passable down there. This this next song you just might have heard. It was a semi-hit in the British Isles and Germany. I think it has also played a fair amount up here. It's about that American creation, the disc jockey. Now, most people don't realize, when you hear a disc jockey on the radio, that they have perhaps the most lonely profession ever. Because what they do is they sit in a room that is 8 feet by 10 feet, maybe 10 feet high, and they have a one-man or one-woman party. All they do is communicate to the microphone, and there's a hope that there's somebody out there watching. No, not watching. Ears. Listening. TV. Somebody's watching. Okay. Glad you caught me on that, Doug. But anyway, the point is that this is a story about a guy who's been at the business for 20 years. 30 years maybe, and he's 45,
going on 15.
Hello, honey, it's me. What did you think when you heard me back on the radio? What did the kids say when they knew it was their long-lost daddy-o? Remember how we listened to the radio, and I said, that's the place to be. And how I got the job as an FM jock the day you married me. It was two kids and I was into AM rock, but I just had to run around. It's been 8 years since I left you, babe. Let me tell you about what's gone down. I am the morning DJ at WOLD. Playing all the hits for you, wherever you may be. The bright good morning voice, who's heard but never seen. The drinking I did on my last big gig made my voice go low. They said that they liked the young sound when they let me go. So I drifted on down to Tulsa Glow, but I do me a late night talk show. Now I work my way down home again near the boys in Idaho. That's how this business goes. The bright good morning voice, who's heard but never seen. Oh, feeling all of 45, going on 15. Okay, Steve, you got the bridge, okay?
I got it.
Jerry Lee Lewis style, funky.
I've been making extra money doing high school stuff. I'm the big time guest MC. You should hear me talking to the little children and listen what they say. Never gonna go away.
All right, Steve. Sometimes I get this crazy dream that I just take off in my car. But you could travel on 10,000 miles, still stay where you are. I've been thinking that I should stop this jockin' and start that record store. Maybe I could settle down if you take me back once more. Okay, honey, I see. I guess he's better than me. Sure, old girl, I understand. You don't have to worry, I'm such a happy man. W-O-L-D. W-O-L-D, 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 W-O-L-D. I am the morning DJ on Danish radio.
Radio.
Playing all the hits for you, but you got a long, long way to go. The bright good morning voice, who's heard but never seen.
Good. You know, I wrote about 400 songs during the 1960s before anybody paid any attention. And I think the basic problem was they stank. They weren't very good. The songs, well, they fit into two categories. They were my protest songs, with the basic implication behind them was, if only the world was as truly wonderful as I am, there'd be no problems. And somehow these didn't go over very well. And then there were my cool macho stud ballads. These were things that were rather desperately intended to get someone of the opposite sex horizontal with me, you know. There were things like,
I've had pretty women in my day. Yeah, those long-haired beauties simply ran my way. Yeah. I treat them rotten, they just love me more. And when they came in trouble, I just showed them the door. I'm a dirty old man, and I don't give a damn.
Anyway, I was writing trash like this during the 60s, and nothing was happening. And then came the 70s, and I was writing different kinds of trash. This was a time when I started writing songs where I was the villain or the fool or the idiot in the song, and all of a sudden, I started becoming successful. Now, I don't know what the lesson of this is. Big John likes to say, do what you do best. But anyway, this is a song of recent vintage about that earlier time when I was waging the sexual wars and losing often.
I would not be so stoned if my Mary were here. I don't think I'd have phoned you if my Mary were here. But I'm a sad sack, Sir Galahad, whose sword's around his knees, with a grail no longer holy and a prayer that's saying please. I would not be alone if my Mary were here, but she took off, and Lord, I'm lost. I don't think I'd be drinking if my Mary were here. And I know what I'd be thinking if my Mary were here. We'd be wrapping up a blanket full of cheddar cheese and wine, packing up our camper with a rendezvous in mind. And we'd picnic out in Lincoln Park if Mary were here, but she split, so I got lit. And I'm so sorry that I called you, babe, in the middle of the night. But you're the one who listens when I need a little light. I know we haven't talked since I dropped you in the dirt. I know you're not my lady now, but baby, how I hurt. I would toss away my troubles when my Mary was here, but I'm lost inside the rubble, 'cause my Mary's not here. So could I come on over with my heart in my hands and place it on your pillow, babe, like a rusty old tin can? I'm drunk and seeing double, 'cause my Mary's not here. Once again, be the friend that you've been, and take me in. Please take me in.
There's a weird feeling coming to a country where you're singing, you know, this is the first time we've been on TV here, and not having the standard reaction. See, performers get very spoiled, and if they've got they've had a hit, they always expect when you start playing it, the audience goes crazy and a bunch of things. Well, this song wasn't a hit over here, but it was number one in the United States, and it was a song that was a little bit different than most hit songs, because it was not about Ooby Dooby Doo, I Love You, or some version of that, and about 99% of music fits into that category. It was about being a father and being in the process of messing up with your kid. Anyway, it's a song called Cats in the Cradle. I won't. Child arrived just the other day. He came to the world in the usual way, but there were planes to catch and bills to pay. He learned to walk while I was away, and he was talking before I knew it. And as he grew, he'd say, I'm gonna be like you, Dad. You know I'm gonna be like you. And the cat's in the cradle and a silver spoon, little boy blue and the man on the moon. When you're coming home, Dad, I don't know when. We'll get together then, son. You know we'll have a good time then. My son turned 10 just the other day. He said, thanks for the ball, Dad. Come on, let's play. Can you teach me to throw? I said, not today, I got a lot to do. He said, that's okay, and he walked away, but his smile never dimmed and said, I'm gonna be like him, yeah, you know I'm gonna be like him. And the cat's in the cradle and a silver spoon, little boy blue and the man on the moon. When you're coming home, Dad, I don't know when. We'll get together then, son, you know we'll have a good time then. He came from college just the other day. So much like a man, I just had to say, son, I'm proud of you, can you sit for a while? He shook his head and he said with a smile, what I'd really like, Dad, is to borrow the car keys. See you later, can I have them, please? And the cat's in the cradle and a silver spoon, little boy blue and the man on the moon. When you're coming home, son, I don't know when. We'll get together then, Dad. You know we'll have a good time then. Ooh. Well, I've long since retired. My son's moved away. I called him up just the other day. Said, I'd like to see you if you don't mind. He said, I'd love to, Dad, if I can find the time. You see, my new job's a hassle and the kids have the flu. But it's sure nice talking to you, Dad. It's been sure nice talking to you. And as he hung up the phone, it occurred to me he'd grown up just like me. My boy was just like me. And the cat's in the cradle and a silver spoon, little boy blue and the man in the moon. When you're coming home, son, I don't know when. We'll get together then, Dad. You know we'll have a good
a lot. Got it.
You are very comforting right down in the front, because you seem to know some of the lyrics better than I do. It's nice having a friendly face out there. Talking about friendly faces, this song I really would like to dedicate to the guys in the band. The last time I was here in Copenhagen, I did a played in a club. It was sort of a triumph for me. I played in a club, and nobody knew who I was, which is fine. And I went up and sang a couple of numbers, and it started going over fairly well. And after I sat down, the guy who owned the club came over to me and said, "Excuse me, but you know, I've got a problem. On Sunday, the guy who's supposed to be showing up to sing is ill, and I'm looking for somebody. And I tell you what, if you can come by, I can maybe give you half the door. It'll be about $20 or $30, and I'd love to have you play." Now, I thought this was pretty impressive. Luckily enough, we make a little more than that in the States when we do concerts. But it reminded me of my earlier days when I played in clubs and without the benefit of all this incredible musicianship around me, which actually, as I'm about to go into this song, I probably should introduce everybody. On my left, your right if you're facing the stage, and if you're not, congratulations, you probably got something more interesting going on, is the guy that makes this group sound a little bit different, and the means by which he does that is something he clasps between his manly thighs. One of the finest cellists in the Western Hemisphere, Mr. Kim Scholes. Our lead guitarist and sex symbol, former divinity student gone to hell, with his U.S. Air Force shirt, he's going to hell even faster, our own Dougie Walker, lead guitar. On drums, a guy who looks 17, acts 13, and he's actually 9 years old, but he plays with all the wisdom of the ages, Howie Hot Sticks Field. On bass, a guy who founded this group with me about 6 years ago.
Good Howard Cue.
Yeah, he really is. A thrilling young man. But anyway.
Hi.
How are you, Big John?
Good.
I tell you something. Did you ever think we'd be in Copenhagen singing a TV concert 6 years ago when we were in the Village Gate in Greenwich Village? And there were three people in the audience and four of us on stage.
What was the question?
Well, no, I remember that night because if we'd gotten the audience excited enough to storm the stage, we could have beaten them back. You know, it was one of those nights. But anyway, Big John has a 5-octave range, and you're going to see it in some of the next few songs. And he's a hell of a bass player. My old buddy, former boy soprano soloist at the Grace Church Episcopal Choir for Boys and Men, Big John Wallace.
There you go.
You got it. Last but not least, a gentleman I've played with, at least figuratively, for about 30 years now. He produced our last two albums, singer and songwriter of some note himself, and indeed producer of the new album, I guess it'll be out here in some recent, soon-to-be time. It was made sometime during the 70s. The new album's called Dance Band on the Titanic, and the pianist and conductor for that dance band, my brother, Steve Chapin, on piano. And now you're going to find out why I dedicate this member to the band, this song to the band, and also to all the spastic guitar players in Scandinavia. Get down, cold sweat. You know, I just finally decided this week who I want to be when I grow up. I think I want to be Barry White. You know, he does that thing, goes, "Right on, right on, you and me, darling, we're gonna get it together, often, right on, right on." No, they've done tests, and they find that that lower voice does something physiological to the female of the species. Do any girls out there feel that? "Right on, right on." Sorry, sir, I didn't mean. "Oh, the very day I purchased it, I christened my guitar as my monophonic symphony, six-string orchestra. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. In my room, I'd practice late. They'd leave me alone. My mother said, 'You're nothing yet to make the folks right home.' Oh, I'd play at all the talent nights. I'd finish, they'd applaud. Some called it muffled laughter. I just figured
They were odd. You guys didn't know I was Italian, did you? So I went up for an encore, but they screamed they'd had enough. Maybe I just need a group to help me do my stuff. And so I dream a bass will join me and fill the bottom in. And maybe now some lead guitar so it would not sound so thin. I need some drums to set the beat and help me keep in time. And way back in the distance, some strings would sound so fine. And some piano, and we'd all play together like five musicians should. And it would sound like music, and the music would sound good. And I'm no longer stuck with that same old formula. I'm a man of panic, symphony, six strings.
Hey, now have a little respect, huh? I'm about to do my solo.
Orchestra.
Do it, fingers!
Eat your goddamn heart out, Eric Clapton.
Sheesh, if that's all you want, I know all of his stuff.
I shot the sheriff. Layla! Alone again, naturally.
He should have written that anyway.
Oh, I write love songs for my favorite girl and sing them soft and slow. But before I get to finish, she says she has to go. She's nice and says, excuse me, I've got to find a bar. I think I need refreshment or I hear you play guitar. Oh, I sent a demo tape I made to the record company. Two came back, address unknown, one came back COD. I'm taking guitar lessons, but my teacher just took leave. It was something about a breakdown and needing a reprieve. And so I dream a bass will join me and fill the bottom in. Maybe now some lead guitar so it would not sound so thin. I need some drums to set the beat and help me keep in time. And way back in the distance, some strings would sound so fine. I need all the help I can get. We'd all play together like fine musicians should. And it would sound
a song that's also about music. It's a song about a singer from Dayton, Ohio that got a review in the New York Times that was incredibly snotty. Do you have papers over here that have airs about how intellectual and erudite they are? You know, and they try to write every review in terminology that's, you know, even if you're Danish, you can't quite understand all the big words. Well, anyway, this is a guy who went through such a review, and I made up in my own head what happened before, leading up to that moment, and what happened after. It's the story of Mr. Tanner, and the role of Mr. Tanner is played by our ever-versatile bass man, Big John Wallace. Mr. Tanner.
Mr. Tanner was a cleaner from a town in the Midwest, and of all the cleaning shops around, he'd made his the best. But he also was a baritone who sang while hanging clothes. He practiced scales while pressing tails and sang at local shows. His friends and neighbors praised the voice that poured out from his throat. They said that he should use his gift instead of cleaning coats. It was not till I heard it, and it made him feel so happy, and it made him feel so good, and he sang from his heart, and he sang from his soul. He did not know how well he sang, it just made him whole. His friends kept working on him to try music out full time, a big debut and rave reviews, a great career to climb. Finally they got to him, he would take the fling. A concert agent in New York agreed to have him sing. And there were plane tickets, phone calls, money spent to rent the hall. He took most of his savings, but he'd gladly used them all. But music was his life, it was not his livelihood, and it made him feel so happy, and it made him feel so good, and he sang from his heart, and he sang from his soul. He did not know how when he sang, it just made him whole. The evening came, he took the stage, his face set in a smile. Critics sat watching on the aisle, but his concert was a blur to him. Spatters of applause. He did not know how well he sang. He only heard the flaws. But the critics were concise. It only took four lines, and no one could accuse them of being overkind. Mr. Martin Tanner, baritone of Dayton, Ohio, made his town hall debut last night. He came well prepared, but unfortunately his presentation was not up to contemporary professional standards. His voice lacks the range of tonal color necessary to make it completely interesting. Full-time consideration of another endeavor might be in order. Dayton and was questioned by his friends, but he smiled and just said nothing, and he never sang again. Excepting very late at night when the shop was dark and closed. He sang softly to himself as he sorted through the clothes. His life, not his livelihood.
Oh, hear the angel voices.
It made him feel so happy, and it made him.
I wrote for Johnny Cash to sing, but he was too damn busy with his Amoco gas.
I hear that guitar playing, boy, I know you're doing a song. And if I knew what the fuck you're doing, I just might sing along, but I don't know.
Well, anyway, they break into music like that and hear it again. It's my first and only country and western song, and it's caused rather weird reactions wherever I've sung it. And the thing about it is that, well, it needs your help. I mean, I have to be frank about it. After the first two choruses, if you can help us out, it would be wonderful. Now, it's very simple. The line you have to say is, oh, bananas. Can you handle that? Bananas are a yellow fruit, right? Like that. Oh, bananas. Now, if you want, you can do, you know, a little, but if you want. Okay, so when repetition aids comprehension. You will see after a couple of choruses, you'll get into it. And there's about 87,000 choruses. Okay? So are you about to ready to get excited out there? Are you ready to get excited?
Yeah! Oh,
thank God. Oh. Here we go. Are you ready? I want a two. Yeah. I want two, three. Just getting in the mood, that's all. It was just after dark when the truck started down the hill that leads into Scranton, Pennsylvania, carrying 30,000 pounds of bananas. Yes, there were 30,000 pounds. Hit it, Big John. You got it? That's your part. He was a young driver, just out on his second job, and he was canned. The next day he spaced the fruit for everyone in that cold Scott Center. But children play without despair in backyard slack piles, and folks manage to eat each day just about 30,000 pounds of bananas. Yes, there were 30,000 pounds. We met again, Big John.
Oh, bananas.
Now this is where the song starts building up in momentum and excitement. He passed the sign that he should have seen, saying, ship the low gear for $50 find my friend.
I'm free.
He was thinking perhaps about the warm breath woman who was waiting at that journey's end. Started down the 2 mile drop, the curving road that wound from the top of the hill. He was pushing on through the shortening miles, the wound down to the depot, just a few more miles to go. Then he'd go home and have a ease, that long cramped day away, and the smell of 30,000 pounds. Your turn right now. City spread its twinkling lights below him. But he paid no heed as a shivering thought of the night's delights went through him. He said, his foot nursed the brakes to slow him down, but the pedal floored easy without a sound. He said, Christ! It was funny how he had named the only man who could save him now. He was trapped inside a dead-end hill slide, running on his fair hunchback. Was every one of those yellow green? I'm telling you, 30,000 pounds. Do it to me now! There were 30,000 pounds. Louder! Woo! Oh, where the man made the sweeping curve that led into the steepest grade. The thankful passing bus at 90 miles an hour. And he said, God, make it a dream. As he rode his last drive down, he said, God, make it a dream. As he rode his last drive down. And he sighed for 19 neat park cars, lift off 13 telephone poles, hit 2 houses, rooted a tree, who caused 7 people. Then he lost his head, not to mention an arm or two before he stopped. And he smeared for 400 yards along the hill that leads into Scranton, Pennsylvania. Yes, all those 30,000 pounds.
guys guessed it. Now, you see, the man who told me about it on the bus says it went up the hill out of Scranton, Pennsylvania. Shrugged his shoulders, shook his head, and he said, and this is exactly what he said as closely as I can reproduce it for you now. He said, and I quote,
"Boy, it sure must have been something. Just imagine 30,000 pounds of bananas. Yes, there were 30,000 pounds of mashed banana. A banana. A banana."
Sing it with me.
A banana.
Pump it up.
A banana.
The song that introduced the band and I to American radio was this next song, which is unusual because the average song on American radio is 3 minutes long and Ooby Dooby Doo, I Love You. And this song is 7 minutes long and Ooby Dooby Doo, I Used to Love You. And it's a song about it's a song about a rainy night in San Francisco, but it could be in Copenhagen, it could be in Stockholm or Oslo, Vladivostok, and Hoboken, New Jersey, just as well. It was raining hard in Frisco. I needed one more fare to make my night. A lady up ahead waved to flag me down. She got in at the light. "Oh, where you gone to, my lady blue? It's a shame you're under your gown in the rain." She just looked out the window. She said, 16 Parkside Lane. Something about her was familiar. I could swear I've seen her face before. But she said, "I'm sure you're mistaken." And she didn't say anything more. It took a while, but she looked in the mirror. Then she glanced at the license for my name. A smile seemed to come to her slowly. It was a sad smile, just the same. And she said, "How are you, Harry?" I said, "How are you, Sue?" Through the too many miles and the two little smiles, I still remember you. It was somewhere in a fairy tale. I used to take her home in my car. We learned about love in the back of a Dodge. The lesson hadn't gone too far. You see, she was gonna be an actress, and I was gonna learn to fly. She took off to find the footlights. I took off to find the sky. Oh, I
Much more for us to talk about. Whatever we had once was gone. So I turned my cab into the driveway, past the gate and the fine trim lawns. And she said, we must get together, but I knew it'd never be arranged. Then she handed me $20 for a $2.50 fare. She said, Harry, keep the change. Well, another man might have been angry, and another man might have been hurt, but another man never would have let it go. I stashed the bill in my shirt, and she walked away in silence. It's strange how you never know, but we'd both gotten what we'd asked for such a long, long time ago. You see, she was gonna be an actress, and I was gonna learn to fly. She took off to find the footlights, I took off for the sky. And here she's acting happy inside her handsome home. Me, I'm flying in my taxi, taking tips and getting stoned. I go flying so high when I'm
good. I want to thank you for this time you spent with us. We're going to end with the theme song from our next album. The reason I called it Dance Band on the Titanic is because I feel that a good deal of the entertainment industry these days has the same function as that peculiar and particular band. You see, their job was to create diversions in the ballroom so that nobody worried about the iceberg outside. So come with us now. It is 1912. It is April the 12th. We're in the British Isles, and the triumph of technology. The first time man has conquered nature. The unsinkable vessel is about to set sail on its maiden voyage, and you are there.
The iceberg's on the starboard bow. Won't you dance with me?
Well, my mama stood crying at the dockside, saying, please, son, don't take this trip. I said, mama, sweet mama, don't you worry none, 'cause even God couldn't sink this ship. Well, the whistle blew, and they turned the screws. It turned the water into foam. Destination, sweet salvation. Goodbye, home, sweet home. We're in the dance band on the Titanic. Sing near my God to thee. The iceberg's off the starboard bow. Won't you dance? Trombone and a saxophone. The bass and drums were cooking on the bandstand, and I was strumming in the middle with this dude on the fiddle. We were 3 days out from land, and now the foghorn's jammed and moaning. I hear it groaning through the misty night. I heard the lookout shout down, there's icebergs around, but everything
everything's still all right. We're in the dance band on the Titanic. Sing near my God to thee. The iceberg's on the starboard bow. Won't you dance with me? They're burning all the flares for candles in a banquet that they're throwing in first class. And we were blowing waltzes in a ballroom. The chaplain say, women and children and chaplains first. Well, they soon used up all of the lifeboats, but there are a lot of us still left on board. That's when I heard the drummer saying, boys, just keep playing. Now we're doing this dead for the Lord. We're in a dance band on the Titanic. Sing near my God to thee. The iceberg's on the starboard bow. Won't you dance with me? There's a wild-eyed boy in a radio shack. He's the last remaining guest. And he's tapping in a Morse code, friends and mama. He's tapping, please, God, S.O.S. Ship go down. We're in the dance band on the Titanic. Sing near my God to thee. The iceberg's on the starboard.